building block model, an area where we have good number of case studies. Also, it got tested once in RTP. I see a question coming in exam soon on this building block model. Now, in order to do building block model, you need to know there are certain things called as standards, certain thing called as dimensions, certain thing called as rewards. If you know them, you can answer it. If you don't know them, we are done. Well, nothing can be done in that question. First thing is standards. What is standards? Is targets. Standards means targets. All are non-financial measure. I'm not going to get into financial measure. Maybe it can become a subpart of our analysis, but most of it will only discuss on non-financial measure. The first thing is standards. What is standards? Is targets. So every organization should have targets for their employees. Every organization should have targets for their employees, and these targets should give them some rewards. These targets should give them some rewards. What are they saying on targets? Target should be equity achievable ownership. There are 10 article assistant in my office. The targets for all of the 10 should be equally challenging. Targets for all 10 people should be equally challenging. There is a finance function, there is a sales function, there is a R&D function. The targets cannot be compared, but the challenge aspect should be equal. You cannot have a favoritism over one article assistant. You cannot have favoritism over one department. So the targets which I set should be equally challenging for all employees, all departments of the company. That's the first important thing. Second, whatever targets you are setting in, there should be a sense that it is achievable. There should be a sense that it is achievable. If it's not achievable, gone. If ICAI suddenly says that 90 out of 100 is the passing marks, nobody will get into this course, because till now nobody has scored 90% in exams. So nobody is going to get into course, because if you're going to say that the passing marks is going to be 90, and people, it's gone. It's a gone case. Nobody is going to even put efforts. I'm not going to even put any efforts to achieve the target, because I very well know that targets are not going to be achieved. If you're going to give me a target which is not achievable, what is the point of setting that target? Because you are setting a target so that you don't pay me any bonus. So targets equally challenging, and I should have a sense of achievability. If these two are there, I will have ownership over the target. I will have ownership. Ownership is, I am saying I will take care of this. I tell my manager, don't worry about this audit. I will take care of this audit. I am taking the ownership of this. You don't even worry about it. I'm taking the responsibility, and I will try to perform because I felt it's challenging, it is achievable. And when the targets were set, this guy called me. We had a discussion. He said that I'm setting a target like this. We spoke with each other. We did something called as a participative budgeting process, and we agreed on saying that we'll complete the audit in 10 days. So everything is great. I have done this. Then suddenly the article assistant says, you are telling me to do this work. What is the benefit for me? Why are you telling me to do this work? Maybe the article assistant example may not be a very good example, but because for you, it's more of learning at this point of time. So monetary rewards may not really matter. But there are set of organizations, set of people who work for monetary rewards in the end also. So you told me all of this. I said, I'm okay to do it, but why should I do it? You tell me, no, what is the purpose of doing it? Then I say, I'll give you rewards. Rewards should be motivational, clear, and controllability. There are three aspects: motivation, clear, and controllability. So I tell you to do an audit, and I say, you complete the audit, I'll pay you 100 rupees. And you say, I'm least bothered about it. How does 100 rupees really make a difference to me? It's not even motivating me. I just say that I'll give you 100 rupees, and you are saying it doesn't really even motivate. Is this a reward this guy wants to give? Then I say, we will pay you extra 1 month bonus. Then you are suddenly motivated. You feel that, great, this guy is saying me something. If I achieve this, I'll get 1 month as bonus. I'm very much motivated now to perform. So it should motivate me, and it should be clearly communicated to me. There should not be any ambiguity. You cannot tell me something and suddenly say that, I say that you have to complete the audit in short time. Now, who knows what is the short time? You're not even defining it. I just say that complete the audit in short time. Then I say, you should meet the expectation of the company. Now, I don't know what is the expectation also. You're not even clearly telling me what you want me to achieve. If you tell me, complete your audit in 5 days without any complaint from the client. Oh, great. I understand what is needed. And there should be controllability. You tell me to complete the audit, but the audit report has to be signed by the manager. The audit report is to be signed by the manager. And this manager is purposefully delaying stuff. This manager is not signing the audit report. Now, how am I responsible for it? So, when things are told to me, my reward should be based on factors which are within my control. My rewards should be based on factors which are within my control. It's very, very critical that you know this. First is, there should be some targets. Target should be challenging for all. It should have a sense of achievability and I should take ownership of it. So performance measure should be equally challenging, should be realistic, should be acceptable to everyone. Employee should be involved in identification rather than being imposed on them. Okay, you do this, great. If you are doing this, then I say, can you give me something in return? What is it for me in this? Then I say, I'll give you reward. So motivation, just a minute. Yeah, reward scheme should be set in a manner which motivates employees to achieve the business goals. Reward scheme should be clearly communicated to employees. What kind of performance will be rewarded and how will this performance be measured? Employees should only be rewarded or penalized of the result over which they have influence. Now, I cannot say that you'll have to complete the audit in 5 days even if your client does not give you information. If the client doesn't give me information, how will I complete the audit? I can complete the audit only if the client gives me the information, no? So where is the point of completing the audit without giving information? So based on factors which are in my control, if I'm able to do this, if I'm able to do this, somewhere these four things will improve. Will improve and this will lead to better results. This will lead to better results. If targets are set in, rewards are introduced, you will be able to improve the quality of service. There'll be some flexibility in the organization to meet some peak demand, to meet some unusual requirements of client. There'll be some innovation which will be done. Some resource utilization can be tracked. Resource utilization is how much the key resources can be people in an organization, so how these resources are being utilized. So these are the determinants of your performance. In order to have good performance in all these four determinants, you should set standards and give a reward structure. So what are the determinants? Quality. Quality is customer satisfaction. Flexibility is ability to meet the customer needs. Innovation is bringing in new products. Resource utilization is making proper use of the available resource. If this is done, profits will improve. Performance as compared to competitors will improve. Competitive performance is your performance in relation to your competitors. Financial performance is your performance in relation to the targets which you have set in. So, quality, ability to deliver goods and service with consistency. Quality should be viewed from the eye of the customer and it should be enough. Flexibility, responsiveness to change in the factor influencing the business. Just to give an example, in Bharadwaj Institute, when COVID impact started, we were not done with our classes. Suddenly COVID happened and we were flexible enough to move to something called as recorded classes. Then we learned that there is also a possibility of taking live online classes. So we quickly moved to this. That explains our flexibility. Innovation, ability to devise new products, because it's very critical that you are bringing in new products. If you are bringing in new products, then only you can succeed over a longer period of time. And resource utilization is ability to make use of resources. Who are the resources? Men, material, machine, money. Men, material, machine, money. The end impact of this is your financial performance will improve. What is financial performance? Budgeted profit, actual profit. Budgeted sales, actual sales. Budgeted ROI, actual ROI. Budgeted EVA, actual EVA. So all this will improve. These are the performance areas that influence the results. Results is explaining the success or failure. I keep saying I have a very good quality product. at some point of time, it should reflect in financial performance. It should reflect in competitive performance. My performance in relation to the competitors. My performance in relation to the competitors. Now, we are going to see case study on building block model. But the only thing is, if you don't know that there is a classification like this, you forget about answering a question on your this. You need to know that there is a standards, there are rewards, there are determinants, there are results, dimensions of performance. If you know this, you can answer the question. You don't know this, you forget about answering the question in exam. Any doubts on this? I'll start taking you through a case study now. Just to summarize building block model again, it focuses on having standards which will lead to rewards and which will help in improving the determinants that will have a final impact on the results of the company. Standards are something which should be equity, achievable, and ownership. Rewards should be motivating, clearly communicated, and should be controllable. Determinants of my performance is quality, flexibility, innovation, resource utilization. And this will lead to results, which is financial performance and competitive performance. Anything you want me to discuss, let me know. Otherwise, I go to case study. Again, I'm repeating, you don't know these items, forget about answering a case study in exam then. If you know these items, you can answer it. If you don't even know the items, I don't know how will you answer the question. Okay, let's now see it. I'll take maximum case studies from your material itself, from the ICI material. Some I'll give homework. Okay, let's come to page 147. Question 39. Question 39, page 147. Before reading the question, let me see what is the exact requirement. Though the heading tells me what is the requirement, but in an exam scenario, advise the partners how building block model at Grab and Co. could be implemented. If you don't see this, you'll not even know the context and you'll keep reading the question. So finally, I get to know that it's a question on building block model. It's a question on building block model. They want to know how can this be implemented. Implemented means how to bring in standards, how to bring in something called as rewards, and also how to influence your determinants, and how finally it can help in improving the performance. Grab and Go is a fast food joint operating in a very competitive business environment. It's a profitable business with very good prospects for growth. Strategy development meeting is underway to chalk out a plan to improve business growth. So talking about a food joint, following information is given to you. Grab and Go has the following mission statement. Derive strength to grow in scale using our passion for the craft of cooking and service that will satisfy our customers, employees, and other stakeholders. So they want to satisfy customers, employees, and other stakeholders. Grab and Go is a closely held partnership firm with 5 partners. It started at a scale of operation that catered to the local demand within a locality. Reputation for good quality food and service has helped it scale up its operations in the recent years. Most of the key decision relating to operations, like decision about the menu and its method of preparation, product pricing, finance, marketing, are centralized. Skilled chef manages for various functions and the firm's partners are part of the core team. So it just gives a background that there is a core team which is available. They take care of the important decisions like menu, method of preparation, product pricing, finance, everything. And there are 5 partners in the company and their mission is to grow in scale by providing good quality service and help them in satisfying customers, employees, and other stakeholders. A general survey published in a food trade magazine highlighted people's perception about fast food joint. this is into fast food joint, and some perception about fast food joint is coming, fast food diet. Predominant opinion was that the current food platter available in food joints across the town were not healthy option. Fast food, they are saying it's not healthy. People want healthier choices in the menu when they dine out. At the same time, they do not want to compromise on taste or presentation. Healthy with taste and good presentation. The other focal point for improvement was the order taking system. In most food joints, the current system is manual, where the order taking staff note down a customer's order on paper, send it to the kitchen, and then deliver the order on intimation from the kitchen, which is also done manually. The system has problems like error in taking down orders. Most times, delivery staff are unaware of the content in an item or its availability. Delays in delivery leading to customer complaining about food served cold. These are very much relatable items for us. We would have seen this in practical world. This problem takes away the pleasure of dining out and is leaving customers dissatisfied. Another scope for improvement is that customer want more payment option other than cash to settle their bills. With the advent of plastic money and mobile, e-wallet payments carrying cash around has become cumbersome for most of them. The partners have decided to use this as an opportunity to develop Grab and Go as a niche food joint, addressing the customer's concern while managing to remain profitable. So some of the concerns which are there of customer, they want to address. Consequently, Grab and Go plans to expand, providing more choices along with its regular menu to health conscious customers. Also, revamping its order delivery and payment system would improve customer experience. A reasonable return of 25% is needed. So some financial data is coming. Capital structure will remain unchanged. Capital structure is the ratio of debt equity. Partners are not interested in diluting their stake by bringing in new partners or take external funding. They may, however, utilize bank financing for expansion. All these points will somewhere come when we write it, okay? Expansion of business will entail opening new branches as well as forging franchise with other stakeholder. So if you have to expand, you'll have to open new branches, go for franchise agreement. However, Grab and Go is not clear as to how to measure market share. Since the fast food industry market is not entirely an organized sector, there's no clear information about the overall revenue. So they are not sure how to measure the market share. In the past, it was quality of its product that drove growth. The management wishes to maintain some data on quality is coming here. High quality standards across branches and franchise. Therefore, an internal quality control department may be established to look into the same. External certifications from government food inspector and other recognized agencies would also require to be met. Quality refers to both product quality and service quality. So when I'm going to a restaurant, I want good food, also good service. The staff and Grab and Go are also excited at this opportunity. Expansion would present a more dynamic work culture. Chefs would have the opportunity to enhance their skill by trying out various ways to cater to the customer's palate. Ordering and delivery staff would have the opportunity to enhance their people management skill. Learning opportunity would definitely be an impetus for their career growth. With expansion, chances of promotion. Better business leads to expectation of better pay and reward system. So somewhere on the reward side, something is mentioned. Consequently, the management is intent on developing a performance management system that tracks performance across the organization. Among the different model, building block model is being considered. Only here I get to know that this is a question on building block model. Till now, I never knew that this is a question on building block model. This is a question on building block model, and I need to focus on building block model. I'm going to take you through the answer. I'll take you through the answer which is there. And obviously, after one case study, I'll give you some time to go through the answer, and then I explaining the answer to you. Okay. The answer will revolve around three areas: dimensions, standards, rewards. In any order you can write it. You can first start with dimensions, then talk about standards, then talk about rewards, or you can start with rewards. Anything is fine. Can you tell me what are the six items in dimension? One person, tell the six items in the dimensions. Can someone tell me the six items which are there in dimensions? Okay, can someone tell me the two items of the results? What are the two items in results?
Financial performance and competitive performance.
Financial performance and competitive performance. Can someone tell me what are the four items of determinants which influence this performance?
Quality, innovation.
Quality, innovation, flexibility.
Resource.
Yeah, resource utilization and flexibility. Coming to the first item, quality, I see this para to be relevant to the quality data. This para to be relevant to the quality data. So what I will talk about quality is the products which are getting manufactured, or basically the food which is getting cooked, should meet my internal quality guidelines. It should also meet the external certifications which are there. I also need to ensure that a good quality service is provided to the customer. And quality does not mean quality only in my main office. The quality should be ensured in my branches, which are in my control. Franchisee, which are not in my control. There are franchisee which I'll give. They are not in my control. If somebody messes up with a franchisee of Domino's, it's finally going to impact Domino's performance. So franchisee, when I'm giving, I need to ensure that these guys are also taking care of the quality needs. Lot of organizations don't give franchisee. That's because if the franchise do not perform well, I will get impacted. I'll come to the quality. Internal quality checks and meeting external certification for all branches and franchisee. Periodic training programs can be given to improve service quality. Periodic training programs can be given to improve service quality. What kind of flexibility should a restaurant have? If you go to a restaurant, what kind of a flexibility do you see a restaurant to have?
Like if there is a change in menu, like I don't eat mushrooms, so I can tell in this dish, please don't add mushrooms. Something like that, flexible.
Flexibility in food menu. I would want certain items to be removed. What other items of flexibility should they have?
Varieties of food, sir.
Variety of food. Technically not. Will I don't see it coming in flexibility. But anyway, I'll see it. Anything else do you see?
The service they offer, like parcel, takeout.
So what is the flexibility you see in that?
That is if I'm not able to finish the food and if I ask them to parcel, then...
Okay, take care. So that is required. So if I'm asking for food, see, what is flexibility is responsiveness to change. Anything which is uncertain needs flexibility. What is uncertain in a restaurant is one time only 10 people will be there in restaurant and suddenly a crowd of 200 people can be there. 200 people can be there. I should be flexible enough to serve 200 people as well as 10 people because there is going to be seasonal variation. Within a day also, there could be a lot of variation in demand. This variation in demand, my ability to meet it effectively, I meet it, I quickly serve this customer, he has his food, he leaves, the next customer comes in, he starts having his food. So I need to serve him even when there is a peak demand. During the peak demand, if you are able to serve your customer well, it describes the flexibility in operations. Apart from that, if at all, ability to hire staff quickly, these are the points there. Catering to seasonal surge in demand. Catering to season surge in demand. These are the points which are there. Let's not worry about whether your point is there or not. You need to write logical. Now you will be able to relate little better when you see it. That's why I discuss. And don't see other points. Please don't focus on seeing other points because I have to keep moving. So I'm just telling you to focus on this. Ability to hire staff quickly, catering to seasonal surge in demand. What points are critical in innovation from a restaurant point of view?
Adding new items to the menu is an innovation. Perfect. Or making Perfect. The same product in different methods.
Making the same?
Making the same item in different methods.
Okay, so that will finally add to the taste. There's one thing which they have talked about in the question. I want you to relate to that. There's something they have talked. What have they told
healthier ingredients to the food.
Sorry?
Adding more healthier ingredients to the food.
Healthier ingredients to the food. Perfect. That is one thing they have talked about.
Sir, taking orders automatically, sir, in a computerized manner rather than manually inputting it.
Okay, so I'm doing an innovation in my. It's a good example of innovation. I'm not sure whether that's there in the answer, but it's a very good example. I would, in fact, write this in my final answer if it's not there. I'm trying to revamp my order and delivery system so that in this revamping, I ensure that these mistakes, revamping the ordering and delivery and payment system so that these mistakes which are there do not happen. Healthier options are given to my customer. I keep adding new items to my menu. Experimentation with inputs to make them healthy while meeting the taste and presentation preference. Taste should also be there, presentation should also be there, but they should be healthy. So you'll have to balance. It should be a constant thing and not a one-time exercise. You cannot just introduce one time and leave it. You have to constantly keep introducing new things. So I will measure it through number of new variants introduced. Everything can be measured. Quality can be measured by meeting your internal or external certifications. Innovation can be measured through number of new variants introduced, regularity of their introduction. Flexibility can be measured by your ability to meet the seasonal surge and demand. I would bring in that revamping the order and delivery and payment system as part of innovation. Resource utilization is making full utilization of the resources. Resources are people, men, material, machine, money. Now tell me, what factors do you want me to write in resource utilization? What factors? See, don't worry about your answer matching, not matching. Sometimes it will match, sometimes it will not match. But logical discussion. I want logical discussion. Some of you have added logical points, so you'll have to keep adding points. What will you write in resource utilization? What do you see as a relevant point in resource utilization? There's nothing right or wrong. Again, I just want participation. So if you start, I can then add on and then tell you the answers.
So ingredients which we are using for cooking should be used in a very optimum way. They should not waste.
Okay, so something like an input-output ratio. Basically,
delivery staff and maybe vehicle for it.
Delivery staff and
vehicle.
So what should I do? How do I measure, or what do you want to do?
Like
you went in the right direction. So.
Like in how many, like in 1 hour, how many the deliveries they do?
Perfect. So a lot of organizations track an item called as number of deliveries per person per day, number of deliveries per hour, number of delivery kilometers traveled. This is from a delivery point of view. If I'm having a delivery system, I will track it. For in-house, what I also track is number of customers served by one waiter, the amount of time a waiter is sitting idle, the amount of time a waiter is required to do overtime. So overtime or idle time of waiter, chef can be tracked. Number of deliveries being done can be tracked. It's basically, finally, what you will get is XX per person, XX per hour. You'll have to build some ratio and track it. You'll have to build some ratio and track it. Capacity utilization, overtime or idle time of kitchen, ordering and delivery staff, turnaround time is the time taken to deliver the order to the customer, table occupancy rate. What percentage of table is occupied? It's a good thing to track whether I'm able to. A lot of hotels will not be able to operate at full level, so they would like to track this. Breakage or wastage of material. One of you have told about the wastage of material. That is also being tracked here. Any doubts? Now, all of this is going to impact my financial performance and competitive performance. In financial performance, what I should track? There is one thing they've already talked about. What should I track in financial performance? There is one information there in the question. For tracking financial performance, what should I measure? ROE should be 25%. That is one thing which they have clearly given. ROE should be 25%. In order to improve ROE, maybe I will track GP margin, NP margin, efficiency of asset usage, asset turnover ratios. So I'll track all of that, but finally I need ROE of 25%. Institute also said that they are not interested in diluting the stake by bringing in new partners. So if you are making profits, don't declare them as dividend. Keep it for your future expansion, because you will need money for future expansion. You may need money for future expansion. ROE of 25%. No plan for doing listing, and hence sufficient profits to be retained. Performance measures like GP ratio, NP ratio, operating margin, ROCE, cash profit, changes in cash reserve. Track it at a firm level as well as at a branch level. All these items need to be tracked. Not only at a firm level, you will have to track it overall at a branch level. Competitive performance is analyzing my performance as compared to the other competitors. Now, how do I measure this? What items do you want me to track to measure this?
Market share.
My market share as compared to others, difficult to measure, but still I would like to track it. If I can get market share, and another way of getting a market share is through some published sources. If they are available, they will give you market share data. If that's not possible, a customer feedback can indicate. If customers are more happy with me, it can indirectly indicate that my market share is moving up. So that is one major indicator. And also they are talking about the spread of the menu available. The menu which I'm having should have a lot of items, and they should be regularly introducing new items. Limitation of information. Okay, I didn't talk about this. Number of branches or franchisee the firm is able to open. Number of branches or franchisee the firm is able to open. If I'm opening more branches, it means I'm growing at a higher pace. If I'm opening more branches, it means I'm growing at a higher pace. Spread and uniqueness of my menu as compared to peers. Spread and uniqueness, which is measured through customer feedback, published or research sources. This is basically a proxy for your market share. Proxy for your market share. Any doubts till now on the dimensions, results and the determinants? Any doubts on the six items? This is a 20 mark case study, okay?
So competitive performance, we can't put it into like absolute values, no?
Can be, can for be. Example, Bharadwaj Institute can do it, because we will have data of other competitors. I can get their financial statements if possible, if they are listed or something. So somewhere it is possible, not exactly. Some data you can compare. Many data you may not be able to compare. One approach is market share. If you're able to measure the market share. So mobile markets, if Xiaomi wants to compare their performance with competitors, they can do it. Xiaomi versus Samsung versus Apple, that is possible. Any doubts till this? Then I have to talk about standards. What are the three rules for standards? What were those three rules? Standards are targets.
Clear. Motivation and that is controllability.
That is rewards. Rewards.
Equity, achievable, and ownership.
Yeah, equity, achievable, and ownership. More of general explanation will be there. I think in rewards they have a specific explanation. Standards, ownership, who's responsible for achievement? There is a core team which is available. So they can be responsible for certain decision, and at the particular staff, there are at the particular branch, there are people who can be held responsible for decisions being taken there. Achievability, achievable plus involvement of managers in target setting. In short, the target should be achievable. If it's not achievable, then things are gone. People will not be even happy to even work on these targets which you are setting. Equally challenging for all. It should be equally challenging for kitchen staff, order and delivery staff, finance staff, advertising staff, everyone. It should be equally challenging. Then rewards should be motivational, clear, and controllability. So for clear communication, I may bring in an HR team so that they communicated properly to my employees. Controllabilities, it should be based on factors which are within the control of that branch. If you're evaluating the performance of a branch, don't put in a head office expense there and say that your performance is not good. So take factors which are in the control of the branch. So clear motivation is basically the reward should be such that I feel that I should achieve it. My performance should be better so that I'm able to get bonus out of it, and the bonus should encourage me. Bonus should not be a number which is not encouraging me. It should be a number which should encourage me. Goal clarity and participation in target. Every organization does this fixed and variable bonus structure. This variable bonus structure is needed so that you can motivate your employees. Clear communication based on controllable financial and non-financial. These are more of general in nature. Anything you want me to discuss in this case study? Now I'll give you time to read through the answer. You will appreciate the answer a little better now. Anything you want me to discuss? Go through the answer to this case study. I don't know the page number. You can look at the page number in your main answer. Could be some 65 or so. It is there in page 82. Do a quick reading of this, maybe 2 minutes, 2 to 3 minutes. This was a 20 mark question. Your answer need not be this detailed. Read through this. You want me to explain anything, let me know. But this is how your answer. So those points in the PPT will tell you what are the critical one. But unless you practice writing one answer, you will not get that comfort. I can give you the time to write answer in a class, but the problem is it takes huge amount of time. This itself took 30 minutes to explain. I'll discuss few more case studies also in building block. Do let me know if there are doubts or you want a different approach to discuss this. The key points are there in the PPT. Sorry. Any doubt?
No, you are now unmuted.
Reconnect to the class.
Okay. I hope you have gone through it. If you are still going through the answer, let me know. I'll wait for a minute more. And again, I'll tell you the answer given in ICI material is very exhaustive. In exam, the expectation is your answer will be half of this. That's the expectation. They are not expecting you to write so many things. Best thing to do in exam is everything, write it in points. 2-3 points about every area. It's not the length of your solution. What will matter is the quality of your discussion. Okay, I hope I can proceed. Anybody want me to discuss anything else? Otherwise, I'm proceeding. Question 29 is done. 30 is part of balance scorecard. I'll move it to balance scorecard from next batch. This is a question on building block model. A service business has collected some figures relating to its year just ended. So it's more of calculation. Customer inquiries, new customer, existing customer. Business one, new customer, existing customer. Types of service performed, service A, service B, service C. Employee, service A, service B, service B. Calculate figures that illustrate competitiveness. Competitiveness is competitive performance and resource utilization. Using this data, I have to calculate only, not comment also. I have to calculate figures which will illustrate competitive performance and resource utilization. Now tell me, what should I do here? How can I analyze my competitive performance here? Or first tell me resource utilization, that's easy. Competitive performance, at least I'll explain. How do I measure resource utilization here?
Based on the employees service.
So based on employee service, so what is that metric? You're going in the right direction. What is that metric called? I'll calculate something called as number of service per employee. Number of services performed. Service A, budget was 875 by 5 people. So how many services per employee we know? Actual is 780 divided by 4. Now, competitiveness is my ability to perform in relation to my competitor, and that is being calculated through something called as success rate in converting an inquiry into an order. If I am having a higher success rate, it means my performance is better. If I am having a lower success rate, it means my performance is weaker. So success rate in converting an order, in converting an order, or in converting an inquiry into order. So let's write competitiveness can be measured by computing actual success rates in converting an inquiry into order. In converting an inquiry into order in converting an inquiry into order. This can be compared with budgeted rate to know the performance. With budgeted rate to know the performance. Particulars, budget actual. Success rates. New customer, existing customer. Success rates, new customer, existing customer. The plan was 6,000 inquiries will come, 2,000 will get converted. 6,000 inquiries will come, 2,000 will get converted. So 2,000 by 6,000. It's in percentage, so you'll do into 100. So the plan was 6,000 inquiries will come, 2,000 will get converted into order. This will be very easy for you to understand. Now you'll be able to appreciate these things better. 2,000 on 6,000. Existing customer, 1,500 on 4,000. 1,500 on 4,000. 1,500 on 4,000. 1,500 on 4,000. Actual is 4,000 on 9,000, which means my ability to convert a new customer order is better than the planned one. 4,000 by 9,000. Existing customer, 1,500. I seem to have performed well in competitiveness side. I seem to have performed well because my success rates are high for both. They have not asked us to write comments, so I'm not doing it. But looks like we have performed better. Resource utilization can be measured by computing number of services per employee. This needs to be computed for budgeted as well as actual data. Number of services per employee. We have different category of services given. Service A, Service B, Service C. Three categories of service are there. Service A, B, and C. Service A is 875 by 5. This was the plan. 875 divided by 5. I don't see a need for comment because they've asked calculate. Comments is analyze, but we'll see if they have commented on. But at least I don't see a need. 780 divided by 4. 1575 by 10. 1850 by 10. 1850 by 10. 1050 by 5. looks like everything is going great for this organization. I'm not sure whether I made a mistake with the data, but looks like everything is going great. Your actual resource utilization is also better. Actual success rates are also better. Both look to be better for this organization. Any doubts? Let's see what is there in the answer. I just hope they have done the calculation and not the explanation, but can't. So yeah, just the calculation, success rate, competitive scans can be measured by looking at this figures by how successful it's converting inquiry. Resource utilization can be measured by looking at average services performed per employee. Average services performed per employee. Any doubts on this? I'll come to 32 later on. Let's discuss 33. Something which you will be able to relate better. Okay, I'll come to 33 in a minute. Let me do one more problem where we'll do some solving so that you get more used to this building block model. Let's come to question 35. Question 35. This will have a lot of solving to be done and relating it. Question 35. Animal Farm Company is a company specializing in the veterinary treatment of animals. Services performed by the company are grouped into three categories: domestic, farm, exotic animals. There are several other animal hospitals in the local area, and the owner of Animal Farm, who is also its CEO and chief vet, is very aware of the threats from competitor. Okay, another thing, before even reading, I know that's a building block model, but we'll have to see this. Using the F&M framework for the analysis of performance system, select a performance indicator for any 5 of the 6 dimensions. So they are saying you do it for any 5 of the 6 dimension. We'll end up doing all the 6 also, and use this to measure the performance of Animal Farm. Use this to measure the performance of Animal Farm. There are several other animal hospitals in the local area, and the owner of Animal Farm is aware of the competition. The system used for dealing with customers is as follows.
Sir?
Yeah.
So the question says 6 dimension of performance in the framework, but they are not mentioning it is a building block model. Since okay, it is the performance block is given by
the building block is given by this person, F&M framework. The building block framework, I copied this from ACCA or something. So maybe there
so
they've
the
used
other
this
word
the other name.
Okay.
This building block was created by these two people. And anyway, if they talk about 6 dimension, it is more of this only. There are 6 dimensions. Once I do the other techniques, you will know that there are no dimensions in others. You will not have 6 dimensions in others. Who is also its CEO and chief vet is aware of the medical center receptionist. Okay, customers telephone the company's medical center when they're concerned about their animal. The medical center receptionist then, for domestic and exotic animals, suggest whether or not the animal should be brought into the medical center for examination and treatment. For farm animals, suggest whether a vet should visit the farmer to examine the animal. Give an indicative price of treatment. This is the basic process. Customers cannot bring their animal into the center without first making an appointment. Animal Farm has a policy of employing no more than 8 surgeons who work full time on either domestic or farm animal. Exotic animals are treated by specialists who are not full time employees. These specialists work for the company when required in response to telephone requests for assistance. Full-time vets are paid a salary of $90,000 each per year. In addition, they receive a bonus of 50% if the actual fee exceeds the budgeted fee. The total bonus is equally shared. Some reward structure is mentioned. Full-time vets are also required to deal with complaints from customer about poor treatment or unsuccessful treatment. Owner is committed to keeping the staff fully up to date with current developments. Each vet has a personal development program and is allowed to attend external training and seminar. Statistics, number of vets, budget actual. Dealing with domestic animal, 5 and 3 was the plan. 4 and 4 is the actual. Number of enquiries, 4,000, 15,000, 7 and 12. Number of examinations, 2,500, 12,700. Mix of examination, domestic animal, farm animal, exotic animal, other statistics, fee income, training costs, fees for part-time vet, other operating costs, number of complaints. Repeat business refers to customers who have used the services of animal farm before. I need to put this in those 6 measures. I need to put them in those 6 measures which are there. Maybe I'll give you a minute to go through it. Okay, first thing is financial performance. Any idea how do I assess the financial performance of this organization? I'll anyway discuss
fees,
it.
Income and that
fees, income and okay, you're right. Comparing fees, income, anything else?
Profit okay. Margin.
Yeah, finally they went with the profit itself. Fees income is good, but finally let me look at the profit. So I'll compare the budgeted profit and actual profit and give commentary. So first is financial performance. Financial performance. Financial performance of animal farm. Financial performance of animal farm can be assessed. can be assessed by comparing the budgeted profit with actual profit. By comparing the budgeted profit with actual profit, particulars, budget, actual. By comparing the budgeted profit with actual profit. Fee income. The data are in millions kind of, because I just copy pasted, I didn't change anything. Fee income, 21 lakhs, 22 lakh 50 thousand. Fee income, 21 and 22 50. Less expenses. The calculation part and all will be very, very simple. The only thing is you need to know what needs to be done. Training cost 60 and 80. Fees for part-time doctors. Fees for part-time doctors, 15,000 and 48,000. Other operating costs, 1120 and 1390. There are 2 more expenses. Can you tell me what are those expenses?
Full-time vet salary and bonus.
Salary of full-time vet. And what is the next one?
Bonus.
So salary of full-time vet is we are going to employ 8 people and pay 90,000. 8 people and pay 90,000. It says Full-time vets are paid a salary of 90,000 each per year. In addition, they receive a bonus of 50% of the amount by which actual income exceed the budgeted income. Actual income exceed the budgeted income. Bonus. I think in my solution by mistake, I have missed this item. That's what I remember. So my answer may not match. The book answer may not match. Not sure. So bonus will not be there in the budget. Because budget was 21 lakhs and your expectation was you will meet 21. Bonus is paid if you exceed. So this minus this into 50%. Into 50%. Bonus is difference between budgeted and actual fee income into 50%. Into 50%. I get the profit finally. In fact, I made a loss. So performance is extremely bad. Performance is extremely bad. Performance looks to be extremely bad for the company. Animal Farm has made a loss of ₹63,000. As compared to target of ₹1,85,000. This indicates weakening of performance. Weakening of performance. Weakening of performance. And this could be due to poor performance in four determinants. If something goes wrong there, it'll impact here. So what can go wrong? Quality, flexibility, innovation, resource utilization. I'm not sure what has gone wrong, but something seemed to have gone wrong. It could be that it's due to poor performance, not peer performance. Due to poor performance. Poor performance in four determinants. Competitive performance. Now tell me, how do I assess competitive performance? You should be able to tell now.
Inquiries converted into examination.
Inquiries converted into examination. So, competitive performance. Competitive performance can be measured by calculating success rate in converting an inquiry into treatment. An inquiry into treatment. An inquiry into treatment. Particulars, budget, actual, success rates for new business, repeat business. New business and repeat business. New business and repeat business. $2,500 on 4,000.
How did you get 4,000?
Number of inquiries.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, 2,500 on 4,000. 12,700 on 15,000. 12,700 on 15,000. 3,000 on 7,000. 11 200 on 12,000. 11,200 on 12,000. So we'll write the company has been effective in converting repeat business. However, the success rate for new business is lower than budgeted and has scope for improvement. Next comes quality. Tell me, how do you want me to measure quality? How should I measure quality here?
Number of complaints.
Okay, any ratio can I put? Number of complaints is fine. Is there a ratio I can put?
Number of complaints, number of examinations.
Yeah, number of complaints as a percentage of number of examination. Because if my examinations are going up, naturally some complaints can also go up. So the ratio which they are going to look at is, now write, quality can be measured with number of complaints as a percentage of total treatments done.
Can you show the Excel?
Just give me a minute. Particulars, budget, actual, number of complaints, number of treatments. Just don't write number of treatments. I need to see one thing. Let's first copy the number of complaints. 300 and 410. Number of treatments is 11,900 plus 3,200 plus 100, 15,200. Not very, very sure, but what I remember is in the solution, they removed the exotic animals treatment. In the denominator, they have removed the exotic animals treatment with the logic that exotic animals treatment is taken care by external specialist and on them complaints may not come. I am not doing that. I am taking all the number and let's proceed with that itself. So my answer again will change with the answer which is there. 15,200, 9,500 plus 4,400. To me, this looks more logical. I should have ideally changed the answer. Percentage of complaints. And this looks to be one major problem for me that has impacted my financial performance. Quality is on a declining trend and this could have impacted my financial performance. Quality has declined as reflected in higher customer complaints this would impact customer satisfaction and has also impacted the financial performance. Flexibility. I don't know, how will you measure flexibility? I'll tell you finally what they did, which looked logical to me. How will you measure flexibility here?
So the budgeted number of examinations or treatments which they expected versus how many they actually treated.
That you will get on the resource utilization. No? You will do something on resource utilization there.
Okay. Then maybe based on the inquiries.
Based on the inquiries, what you want me to do?
So we can... Okay, why can't we use the same measure and say that since they were not, so say 4,000 inquiries were made, but they converted only 2,500. It's possible that they weren't able to convert the balance 1,500 because they did not have the flexibility to treat all the that remaining 1,500 inquiries also.
No, but that's more of a success rate because... I gave them the treatment, but these guys were not ready to take it. I would have explained it.
Okay.
I'll tell you what they went with.
Number of vets and number of customer inquiries done.
So that is your resource utilization. I'll tell you what they did. They said that for this animal farm, treating domestic and farm animal is easy. Exotic animal is very difficult. So they said, let's calculate number of exotic animals treatment as a percentage of total treatments done. Number of exotic animals treated as a percentage of total animals treated, which explains my flexibility in treating exotic animals. Because they are difficult to treat. Exotic animals are not so easy to treat. There could be some hybrid version, something. So it's not so easy to treat exotic animals. So my ability to treat exotic animals through a specialist can explain my flexibility in operation. So now, right, flexibility can be measured by the company's ability to treat exotic animals. Number of exotic animal treatments. Percentage of exotic animal treatments. I finally found this to be a very good measure. In fact, makes a lot of logic. And in fact, things went very well here also. Things also went well. It's a very good measure. So the only thing is, it's not that when I saw the case study, I could find this. It's more of practice. I've gone through multiple case studies. So when a new case study come, I may be still in slightly better position to answer it. You also will get into a better position as you keep reading more and more. Because when I asked you for competitive performance, you quickly gave it. Because you were able to relate to the earlier one which we did. Resource utilization. This also will be very easy. Resource utilization. Tell me, how should I measure?
Number of vets and
examination done.
So how, so can tell me the name, what is the ratio called?
Services per employee.
Number of treatment per vet.
Yeah, number of treatment or number of services, number of treatment per vet. We'll classify them into two categories, domestic animals, farm animals. Domestic animals and farm animals. The plan was 11,900 on 5. The plan was 11,900 by 5 people for domestic. 11,900 by 5 people. 11,900 by 5 people. 3,200 by 3 people. 11,900 by 5 people. 3,200 by 3 people. Actual is 9,500 by 4. Here also my performance is looking good. My performance is looking good. I seem to have done better. Seem to have done better. Looks fine. I think this answer may not match. We'll see the answer in some time. I think profit, it's a mistake itself. And this complaints, they have treated it slightly different. Innovation, tell me, how do I measure this? Very, very tricky here. How will you measure innovation? Again, the answer was very logical. I really appreciate the answer which was given.
Something related with exotic animal.
I'm not doing any exotic animal treatment itself, no? Specialists are only going to do. I'm not going to even do exotic animal treatment. They have given something saying that there is some personal development program and all. So what do I do now?
Customer inquiries by telephone, sir. That could be innovative.
But what do you want me to measure? How do I measure? And this is not innovation. This is a normal thing, no? So very much a normal thing.
Operating income versus revenue, sir.
What is innovation in that?
If you have product innovation, operating cost in comparison to revenue. So if you have
product... That's what you did in financial performance, no? See, the best thing they could have given is budget. 8 days, every person has to do this external training. Actual, they did it for 10 days, 12 days. So what they did is, they don't have this data. They said there is this training cost. If you're spending more on training, it indirectly means you're innovative. It indirectly means you're innovating. If you're spending less on training, the innovation component is coming down. The innovation component is coming down. So the measurement was like this. Particulars, wait for a minute. Training cost, number of employees or number of doctors. Training cost per vet. If the training cost is going up, the innovation component is increasing. Training cost is coming down, the innovation cost is coming down. Not a very good measure. The very good measure could have been training days. They could have given the training days in the question. So write this, innovation, training cost, number of vets, training cost per vet. Eight people were needed. In fact, four determinants, things are very good. It's that only one determinant which went well, which went bad, which is customer complaints. Financial performance is bad. Maybe it's a lagging indicator and future could be better for the company. That I don't know. Because other things look very good. Maybe this year I got impacted. Next year I'll see a better performance. Any doubts in this? Now you see this answer, you'll be able to appreciate it better. Some answer can be different. Okay, this I have corrected. This is correct. measure of competitiveness may be success rates. Now this is good for us to know. There are other data which is possible, which is good. Growth in market share, but I don't have data for this. Okay, we calculated for new business and repeat business. Just give me a minute. Okay, we could have also calculated for the overall business. That was not done. Is this same as what we got? 1.97 and 2.89?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then I think I've corrected the answer. I've corrected the answer. Resource utilization, done this way. Another way they have done is revenue per doctor. Okay, I didn't think about it, but this was another way. Revenue per doctor. Revenue per doctor is done. This is another way of treating or calculating the this. And here also they have done overall. We didn't do it. I cannot say that this is exactly wrong, but yeah, this is an area which I can focus on when I do the next question. Okay, it is better to do overall. Flexibility, treatment of exotic animals. Innovation, training cost per vet. Any doubts in this? Any doubts in this? Again, I can repeat only one thing. It will come only with practice. Critical things, critical questions, I'm going to discuss. Some I'll give as homework also. Anything you want me to discuss in this question?
Sir, I have a small doubt, sir.
Hmm.
So with respect to complaints, so the question of yours is that from complaints from customers about poor treatment or unsuccessful treatments, those are the kind of complaints that we get. And we've gotten 300, which is what we budgeted, and 410. So why are we taking this? Why can't we take this as a percentage of just new business to say that if a new business person comes in, or rather if a new customer comes in and he has a complaint, he will not be a repeat customer. So why can't we take it like that, sir?
No, but the repeat customer who has come in, he may complain now and he may not come in future, no? Repeat customer who has come in. So, for example, in Bharadwaj Institute, we get students at inter. The same students come at final. It's not necessary that if they're happy at inter, they'll have to be happy at final. Na? So, these repeat customers can also complain. Na?
Yes,
unless the question gives you a breakup. If the question had said, so many complaints from repeat customers, so many complaints from new customer, you can do that analysis. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's come to question 40. I give you 5 minutes to read it, 5 minutes to think about the answers, and then I discuss. So around 7-8 minutes, around 7-8 minutes at your end, go through the question. It's on building block, which you understand in the last line of the question. It's a question on building block. Always it's better to see the last part to understand what the question is going to ask. So we have two service centers, so technically I'll have to do calculation for both of them and do some comparison. Do some, like we did budget and actual comparison, here the comparison is between one service center and the other service center. Okay, can we start discussion or you still want some time? Do you need some time or can we start? I'm not going to do solving part and all. I'll just do the discussion because calculation is of not much significance, that you can manage it. My focus would be on explaining stuff. This is basically a service center. That's the background. Some website is there and then they get redirected it. Results for the two data points have been given. So the orders come mostly through websites, and from websites the orders gets booked and get closed. I have to put it under the six parameters: competitive performance, financial performance, quality, flexibility, resource utilization and innovation. Competitiveness, can you tell me what is the factor I have to monitor? Competitiveness.
You are now unmuted.
Number of website hits compared with total number of jobs booked and completed.
So what do you call that?
What do you call that?
What is the ratio?
What is the ratio you want to call?
Number of jobs booked and completed as by number of website hits.
Okay, so you have given me the formula. So I'll tell you what we will do is we'll say success rate in converting a website hit into an order. Success rate. So again, it's success rate basically. Success rate in converting a website hit into an order. 9506 by 14,000, 11870 by 18260. This is what should be there in the solution. success rate in converting an order. Financial performance. How do I measure financial performance here?
GP margin.
GP margin, gross profit by sales in 200. I can compare and then give commentary on it. Commentary part and all, you can see it later, but I can do that. Quality.
Number of repeat customers to total number of jobs.
Percentage of repeat customer. There's one more important thing. Yeah, customer feedback rating, that to me is more important, but they gave both percentage of repeat customer and customer feedback score. Customer feedback score. So that'll tell you whether I'm doing better or weaker. Innovation.
Number of new service pack developed.
Anything better than that? That is one good, but can I make it better?
Profit per service pack.
Where is the profit per service pack? Where do I have?
Total plus fine gross time spent.
Number of service packs.
No, profit nahi. It is based on new service pack only. Something related to new service pack. So
sales
what?
And new customers.
What you have is you have the revenues also of this. So what they did is percentage of revenues from new service pack. Percentage of revenues from new service pack. That is 66 plus 58 plus 54 divided by 760,500. Similarly, 44 plus 42 divided by 890,365. So this will tell you what proportion of your revenues are coming from new customers. That is good, no? Proportion of revenues from new customers. That's always preferable. That's your innovation thing. Resource utilization.
Total time spent.
Is it total time spent? No.
Number of mechanics, sir.
Sorry?
Number of mechanics.
So link it.
Done by each.
Service done per mechanic, 9,506 divided by the number of people. So number of services per mechanic, number of services per mechanic, that will tell you the resource utilization part, whether more services are being performed or less services. And it could be a reason of mix between the senior and junior can also play a part. In my final answer, mix between them can also play a part. What about the last one, which is your... We are done with flexibility, flexibility. How do I measure flexibility? Again, the answer which was given was very logical, but I couldn't think of that answer in the beginning. Flexibility. Okay, it'll be very difficult to imagine this, but this is what they have given us, flexibility. Time taken per service. Time taken per service, they are saying, if you are taking less time, it gives the customer a flexibility to wait and take the car and go rather than depending on other cars. This really happens if I'm able to give it to a service center and he can give my vehicle in 2 hours, I maybe wait and get the vehicle and come back. Or if it's going to take one full day, then I have to depend on a rented vehicle for that day. I'll have to depend myself on a rented vehicle that day. So they took this as a measure. They said a good measure is time taken per treatment, or time taken per time taken per service. How much time are you taking for doing one service? Let's see this quickly. Percentage of website. Yeah,
can we take time taken per mechanic as resource utilization?
Time taken per mechanic. Yes, a good measure. It's a good measure. Percentage of website converted into order, GP margin, percentage of jobs from repeat customer, and they have not talked about rate. It should have talked about customer rating. I'm not sure why they haven't talked about time taken per job. Just a minute. Okay, this is their flexibility is measured through this. Resource utilization is measured through sales per mechanic. In fact, okay, they have gone ahead and measured it through sales per mechanic rather than number of treatment per mechanic or time per mechanic. They have finally said, let's go with revenue per mechanic. Okay, now onwards, if we have revenues also, let's do both. That is what was done in the earlier question. I did not think about this. This is there in the solution. So I am not again saying my answer is going to be accurate. I did not even think about it. I thought it will be number of services per mechanic and revenues generated from new service pack. Revenues generated from new service pack. With this, I end this question. The other one is more of theory. Standards and rewards block is more of theory. What I will do is I'll be giving you some homework question in this area. This is the PPT for that. Competitiveness, percentage of website hits converted, financial GP margin, quality, percentage of jobs from repeat, flexibility, time taken per job, resource utilization, sales per mechanic, innovation, percentage of revenues from new service pack, standards, achievable, fair and ownership, rewards, clear, motivating and based on controllable factors. This is a clear summary of this question. I'll share this PPT also. I will give some homework question, but I'll have to see which is easy for you to do. So I'll be giving that. I'll send that message in the group. If there are any doubts, let me know. We can discuss. Otherwise, I end the session.
Like even what we have discussed and the answer is not accurate. So with the assumption and logical, if it is fine, then it is okay, no?
I would give marks. I'm not sure about ICA, but I'll surely give you marks.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, because it's impossible. See, I did not even think. To me, it makes a lot of sense to even take number of treatment per mechanic. They have given sales per mechanic. So if at all this data is there, let's end up doing both now onwards. Sure, we'll end with this then.